So there's a protest that's going on outside Education Minister Dharmendra Pradhan's house. This is a day after the NTA, the National Testing Agency, announced that it has decided to cancel the UGC NET examination. Remember, this examination was taken by over 11 lakh students. It was held on the 18th of June, and it is the exam that decides the entry-level positions in colleges across the country, also PhD programs. So this is an important examination. The government, the NTA, has in fact said that the integrity of the exam could have been compromised, and the decision was taken after MHA received some very critical inputs from the Cyber Analytics Department, after which it was decided that the matter will be probed by the Central Bureau of Investigation. But those are the visuals that you see. Those are activist workers from the NSUI, which is the student wing of the Congress Party. They are demanding action against NTA and also asking for the resignation of the Education Minister. But the ministry has clearly said that it wants a crackdown on all the culprits involved in this controversy. I have my colleague Ishika reporting from the ground on this protest. Tell us, Ishika, what are the demands of the students and who were the protesters here?
Let me first tell you that it was the student wing of the Congress Party, that is the NSUI, who were protesting, who were holding this flash protest outside the Education Minister's residence here. Now, just a few minutes ago, all of these students who are protesting here, they all have been detained by the Delhi police. But first, let me show you the visuals here. You can see that all of this, you know, that you can see the 500 rupee notes, these are fake notes certainly, but all of this was brought by the NSUI protesters, and they allege that there is a corruption that has been done here in the NEET exam and also in the NET exam, and this is affecting the life of the students. And thus today they demanded the resignation of the Education Minister Dharmendra Pradhan. Now let me also show you that you can see the security that was already beefed up here, you know, getting the information that there will be a flash protest by the student organization. And thus we saw in fact just moments after it started, all of these students who were present here, all of these protesters, they were all detained by Delhi police officials. But certainly, you know, Vasudha, we do see that student organizations, they continue to hold protests outside, you know, the Education Ministry, outside Education Minister's residence here. And they in fact allege that there is a corruption that has been done, and all of this needs to be inquired by an independent agency. These are the demands that the students and the student organization have put forth. But on the other hand, if you look at the government side as well, we have seen how they have said that because an input was received by the UGC that the integrity of the NET exam has been compromised, and that is why a decision was taken that the NET exam that was held on 18th of June will now be cancelled, and the case will now be given to CBI for further investigation. On the other hand, the government was waiting for in fact a report from the Bihar Police's Economic Offences Wing to further take action on the NEET, regarding the NEET exam. But there also a very big development has happened. The alleged accused for the NEET exam, they have in fact accepted that there is a paper leak that had happened regarding the NEET exam. So certainly the government still doesn't, you know, hasn't accepted that there was a paper leak incident that took place for the NEET exam. But the alleged accused in the police custody, they have now in fact accepted regarding the paper leak. So it remains to be seen, Vasudha, as to what action will now be taken by the Education Ministry and by the Education Minister. Because on the other hand, we have seen that the opposition continues to mount its attack on the Education Minister and continues to question the silence of the Prime Minister over this entire issue.
Absolutely. Over to you. Stay with us, Ishika. We also have Aishwarya and Tanushka joining us with more details on the story. Aishwarya, you've been speaking to Education Ministry officials. Tell us, what is the government thinking? Because clearly, on one hand, a lot of people might believe that, you know, this was the right step. You know, as soon as the Cyber Analytics Department gave critical inputs to the MHA, the government did decide to cancel the examination. But there are questions, larger questions, on the working of NTA. NEET controversy is only intensifying by the day, and now NET examination has been cancelled, so clearly disappointment among students would be growing.
Well, certainly the word coming in from the Ministry of Education that it is the Government of India which is committed to hold the examinations again. They will conduct these fresh examinations for the NET, but certainly the sanctity of the examinations was under the scanner after the inputs that was received by the Ministry of Home Affairs and the department that exists under them, which is the Cyber Crime Coordination Department. And soon after receiving those information, the examination got cancelled. Remember, on June 18th, the physical paper was conducted, and after on June 19th, it was the information that was received by the Home Ministry, after which the Ministry of Education had taken a decision that they will cancel these examinations and will conduct a fresh examination, and they will not hamper any sanctity of these examinations, and the fresh examination will be conducted. They are looking it very seriously, and a team had been assigned to look at the conduct of from where these exam papers allegedly were leaked. It has not been disclosed yet that whether the examination paper was leaked or what happened, but of course the Central Bureau of Investigation had been given a responsibility to thoroughly investigate into this matter as soon as they got the information. The Government of India and the Ministry of Education had been very clear that the rights of the students are paramount for them, and therefore the reason perhaps they will conduct a fresh examination, and this examination will be called cancelled. Now on the other side, of course, so on one side there had been several meetings that went inside the Ministry of Education and different departments. Yesterday we saw JP Nadda, Dharmendra Pradhan and Mr. Amit Shah also met, and after this particular decision was taken. But on the other side, yes, to conduct it freshly, what dates would it be, and what rules needs to be set, and a strict procedure needs to be applied this time, is something that the Ministry of Education is also looking for. Today is an important day as far as the Ministry of Education is concerned. We have been told that around 2 p.m. that there is a meeting that would be conducted by Dharmendra Pradhan inside the Ministry of Education with senior officials, and from there some sort of information can also come out as to when these examinations will be freshly conducted, and what information the Ministry of Education can share with those people who had been who had given these examinations, and how they can apply for the fresh examinations for the NET. Right. Certainly we have seen the political war of words also had come out soon after this decision of the government has taken. The opposition parties clearly mounting an attack to speak about this as far as the top ministers are concerned, prime ministers are concerned.
Right.
Why they are tight-lipped, why they are silent on the entire issue. They want an answer and accountability on the entire issue as well.
Right. That's important here as to, like, you know, there could be some clarity, some clarification that could be issued by the Education Ministry. And also, Aishwarya, we've also been expecting more details on what kind of CBI probe has been ordered into this cancellation of UGC NET examination. My other colleague, Tanushka, is reporting from Delhi University, which becomes critical now that UGC NET examination has been cancelled. Let me remind my viewers that 11 lakh students took this examination on the 18th of June. This is the exam that decides appointments. This is the exam that decides admissions to entry-level teaching jobs across universities, government colleges in different parts of the country. So this is a very critical examination. Also, this is the first centrally organized, centrally held examination that has been scrapped now. So clearly many questions being raised there. One would see it as a crackdown on the wrongdoers. Maybe, you know, this is the beginning of maybe action that needs to be taken. Others, of course, would talk about disappointment, growing disappointment among students with NEET controversy and NET controversy. Tanushka, tell us, did you get a chance to speak to students, professors, all the stakeholders there? How is the sentiment on ground? What is the what are people in the university talking about?
Yes, so I'm currently outside the UGC office. This is the Universal Grants Commission office where tried to speak to officials, but the UGC has said that they deny a comment on the issue right now. We must remember that UGC is in the, you know, despite being the major authority conducting these examinations, the UGC NET examinations, they've denied to comment upon the issue. After the cancellation of the exam that took place on 18th of June and a CBI probe is currently on into the matter to look into as to what exactly, what kind of discrepancies or compromise that the Ministry of Education has spoken about has happened. And this is the first time in the history of the NET exams that the exam has been cancelled altogether. And earlier, after speaking to students who appeared for the NET exam, remember there are 81% of the 11.31 lakh students who registered and appeared for this exam across 317 cities in the nation, whose futures now hang in darkness, who have no clue right now that what is next. So these students were raising questions, of course, on the authorities concerned, the Ministry of Education, the NTA, the National Test Agency, as to how is it that these kind of discrepancies are, you know, seeping through the system and exams are still being held in this fashion. The questions that these students raised were, you know, demand for clarity or accountability as to how is it that these kind of things are being gotten away with. They do express a certain sort of satisfaction with the exam being cancelled, as they hope now the exam procedure will be treated with utmost fairness and in a just manner, unlike as to what it has happened. Some students also claim that paper leaks have also happened last year, but it's this time that has come into the public fora out in the open, and that the NTA, even the ministry, has accepted to this sort of a compromise in the integrity and the sanctity of the examination happening. But at the heart and the core of the issue, what the students say is that why is it that, you know, they are at the receiving end of all of this mismanagement or discrepancies or these loopholes within the system? Why is it that they are having to suffer at the end of the day?
So Tanushka, so many questions there, and also, you know, this waiting period has only increased for a lot of students because there'll be a retest now. So clearly there needs to be a lot more planning that also impacts the way logistics of households have to be redone in some ways. Ishika, back to you. Tell us what is happening outside the Education Minister's house. In the last few days, he has come out and he's spoken openly about the problems that exist around NTA. Now, NTA was formed in 2017. It's a body that specifically was given the task of organizing professional examinations. Remember, there are 40 lakh students who take not just NEET, but also the JEE, which decides, both these exams put together decide the entrance, the entry, the admissions to prestigious colleges, medical and engineering colleges across the country. So clearly, NEET is a big controversy. It is aspirational, and it's understandable why the country is thinking about this. Tell us what is happening right outside his house, and are the protests over? Are any more protests expected today?
Well, Vasudha, in fact, currently we are reporting from the Education Minister's residence here, and just a few minutes ago, the protest that was held by the Congress's student wing, that is NSUI, got over when all of these students, all of these, in fact, protesters of the NSUI, all of them were detained by the Delhi police from right outside Dharmendra Pradhan's residence here. And in fact, certainly, there is another protest that we are expecting from the left student's wing around 2 p.m. that will be outside the Education Ministry. And all of these student organization of different parties, they continue to hold protests and demand now the resignation of the Education Minister over the allegations of corruption that they are putting here. And in fact, we also showed you the visuals of the fake cash, that the NSUI protesters had brought here, alleging that there is a big corruption that was done in this NEET exam. And as you rightly mentioned, Vasudha, we all know that the NTA is a very, crucial testing agency that holds very big exams. If we talk about the NEET, if we talk about the JEE, so certainly the government goes on to say that it will take all the steps required to uphold the transparency. But on the other hand, Vasudha, the questions will be asked, because we have seen how there have been allegations of paper leak, and now with, you know, the alleged accused with the Bihar police, you know, they admitting that there was a paper leak done for the NEET exam. Now, certainly the concerns are being raised by the students, by the aspirants of NEET, by their parents as well. So certainly these are the questions that remains to be answered by the Education Minister, Dharmendra Pradhan. But we are expecting that today it is likely that he is also going to meet the students. So all of that remains to be seen. But certainly a big protest by another, you know, left student wing organization is going to be held outside the education, ministry at around 2 p.m. is what we are expecting. So certainly drama continues over this NEET controversy, after, especially after, you know, the NEET exams got cancelled. Over to you.
Absolutely. Ishka, stay with us. Aishwarya, also tell us what could be happening around the education ministry today, because in the last few days we've seen the education minister actually have a dialogue with students. Of course, political workers aside, NSUI aside, he has been talking to students who have had concerns. He has also admitted that there are problems with the NTA that need to be solved. So that has been some honesty on his part. But of course, there are larger questions there which need to be addressed. So what is expected in the education ministry today? Because this has really become a bigger controversy, with the Home Ministry getting inputs that there could have been some problems, some discrepancies, even paper leaks. So it's become like a multi-ministerial problem now. So clearly there's more action, there are more meetings expected, isn't it?
Well, on asked to the officials of Ministry of Education that how the Ministry of Home Affairs was involved, it was stated by them that because it is IFOC and all the cyber activities are being reported to them, it was inputs that was credible input that were received to them as far as the examination is concerned, and the detailed investigation is currently on, and therefore they can't reveal much. But because the inputs was received, it was later shared to the Ministry of Education, and it was stated by some of the officials to us that it was a very hard step, but an important step that they have taken to cancel those examinations, because they do not want the rest of the students to suffer because of the few. In the past, yes, of course, they had got information for various examinations that were conducted, that in few places there are some discrepancies that were found, but that was resolved at that stage only, and that was very minor in the nature. But this time they have received the credible information, the Home Affairs shared this information to the Ministry of Education, and later this important step was taken yesterday, and this for the very first time that an entire examination had been cancelled on these credible inputs. And certainly it is now the work on the part of the officials to do another homework and to finalize the date. Logistics had to be finalized, and later the dates had to be announced. All the information and all the FAQs had to be shared to those students who had undergone these examinations, and how they can apply again, what date it would be, whether it would be suitable for them. There had to be a lot of people who are directly related to the examinations, organizations that they need to again hold talks with to issue fresh guidelines and to issue fresh dates for the examinations. So all of these needs to be done now in a very fast manner as far as Ministry of Education is concerned. And therefore today, since morning, we are witnessing at the Ministry of Education that both the MOS are already present over here. They are conducting several of the talks with the officials, and later we are expecting Dharmendra Pradhan to also arrive at the Education Ministry to hold this all important meeting, which we have been told that will be happen post 2 o'clock. So certainly, yes, a lot of work needs to be done, but a clarity also is needed on the part of those students which have undergone these examinations, which have given these examinations, but now needs to give another examination, and this has been cancelled. So all of this work needs to be done, and therefore the reason perhaps, yes, the meetings are underway at the on the part of Education Ministry, but when can we accept these guidelines to be out is something that remains to be seen.